7 days after the invasion, and Russian forces have launched a major push, taking control of the southern city of Kherson, the first major city to fall. And the death toll is mounting. At least 2,000 Ukrainian civilians have been killed, alongside 500 Russian troops. But as the world continues to condemn Vladimir Putin, there is no sign he's willing to stop. Europe correspondent John Paul Gonzo has this report.
Kharkiv University in ruins as the future hopes and lives of the 44 million people in Ukraine teeter on the edge. Russian paratroopers landed here before dawn as they moved to seize control of the country's second largest city. To the south, Kherson has become the first major city to fall. The mayor writing on social media, he made the Russians no promises, but just asked them not to shoot people. The UK and 37 other countries have reported dozens of alleged war crimes to the International Criminal Court. An investigation is expected to be launched in days. They have orders to erase our history, our country, and all of us, President Zelensky says. But people are still fighting here. Locals built barricades to try to stop Russian forces from breaching one of the country's nuclear power plants.
There is, of course, a risk of attack or the possibility of an accidental hit.
Russian troops already have control over the Chernobyl site, where Valentina Pobedina tells us her dad has been held since last week.
They've been kept there for 160 hours, even more, whereas a normal shift is not more than 12 hours. And their health and their lives in danger.
In a video taken by one of his colleagues, her father can be seen sitting at the back, Russian tanks stationed out the front.
I don't think that they're going to let them go until the war stops.
Despite strong words at the UN today...
End hostilities in Ukraine now. Silence the guns now.
There is no sign of that silence, so locals have taken to living in the relative safety of the underground. This village on the front line of the battle for the capital, Kyiv, only has one bunker, a cellar turned bomb shelter. In here, it's a cold and anxious wait for what's coming. We don't need to be freed, she begs. Leave us alone. There is little chance of that. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First, Shemeshul.